So our conference, as you know, the topic is quite controversial, let's say. Our topic is this one, and I quote the one of the most important poets or writers in the world, which is Shakespeare, and he just discussed that never felt of all, the leader, the recitatrice, the recitatrice, the this is why very many times when we announced the topic of the conference, people said, oh well, yes, it's a problem, okay, but making a scientific conference of this, oh well, you'll be very brave, very courageous of doing this. So well, people are, as you know, underestimating what happens because they never felt it. What we are talking about, this is the definition that the European Commission gives of sexual harassment. Any form of unwanted verbal, non-verbal, physical conduct of sexual nature occurs with the purpose or effect of violating the dignity of the person, in particular when creating an intimidating, hostile, degrading, humiliating, or offensive environment. Every one of us who have had any sort of this kind of experiences, even a lifetime, not even a proper harassment, knows that all these feelings are there when you are the object of this behavior. Luckily enough, we have been in a situation that many universities, many research centers are aware of the problem. One of the most aware, at least in Europe, is in Norway. The University of Oslo has recently done the code of conduct, which many universities have, and it has done analysis of the problem in their universities. There will be a conference a few days from now in the Academy of Mathematical Science, again on the problem. They obtained a very important record, and so many records have been published around the world. There is a book, which is a very heavy one, which presents the question and tries to develop the various developments which we follow during our conference. We, as you've seen, divided into three sessions. What we know, so we, in the first session, we try to give a panorama of the situation, how it is now, what we know about the problem, how to address the problem, so which solution can we find to solve it, and how to address the problem to prevent the problem. So the three phases, knowledge, solutions, and prevention, which of course is, I think, the most important one, at least, of course, they will go in parallel, they're not one after the other, they are in parallel. And this is a multi-phased problem, and there must be multi-phased path to solve the problem. There are different ways, just to quote very quickly, and during the conference, the presenters will go in depth on the questions. So guidelines and common conducts are important because people know how they should behave, and more important, they should know what happens if they don't behave that way. Procedures, guidelines, and as an indicator, we can have the presence or absence of this code of conduct or guidelines in an institution. Training is very important because people should be trained on this because explicit training on the question, I think, is something which will help. Is preventing maybe in the short time, training on awareness, because sometimes training also for women is important, because women say, well, no, well, it was just joking, it was something, it's not joking, it's doing harassment. And so training is an important part, and discussion, diffusion, speaking about the question, letting people speak up, and prepare prefer formal ways of discussion or informal ones, but the formal are important because they are recognized, they are organized, and they help people to speak up and to know how to deal with the problem. So different events, different number of participants, many participants also, of course, and the presence of persons like the ombudsperson who can help and facilitate the solution. A number of policies are, of course, essential because these are immediate questions that will impact actions that can be done, but the policies in behind are very important. So, of course, the presence of the elderly officer, zero tolerance policies for general non-discrimination of people, gender balance organization in events or in the commissions, as an umbrella, equal treatment of workload, equal treatment of pay, and as a background also for this solving this question. So as I said, it's a very multi-faced program and a multi-faced action should be taken to take it into solving the problem. Our conference is in this direction, and how in your own institutions, in your own relevant roles, we call it as a relevant role, as relevant roles, I think, and the same on these women questions. So I hope we help to repeat and to change the situation. Thank you for your attention, and I would like to say that the beautiful drawings were made by my little nice